Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
What's up, YouTube? My name is Chris. I go by Beautiful Loser.
Wait. You don't go by the Beautiful Loser.
Social media wise, I do. Oh. But today I wanted to do I got a lot of shoes and I just got them. Just wanted to do a video to show my collection, you know, instead of just having them sit around the house for nothing. Try to get, you know, sponsors or something, maybe. You know how people, they send people shoes and all that type of good stuff, you know. So I'm going to start. Go random, pick out a shoe and tell you a story behind the shoe, if it's a story behind it. I'm gonna start with these right here, the Confetti Kyrie 4s. I got these the day before they released. I mean, I was big into the Kyrie line, so I usually when shoes this come out, something that's exclusive, I go crazy for it, trying to find it. But I found an Instagram page? Yeah, it was an Instagram page and they sold them for $190, but they're resale ended up being way more after the fact. So yeah, I got a good deal for them. And, these right here, I said, I was big in the Kyrie line. So I was in class, you know, they come out early and I'm well, they say 7, but where we are, they come out at 9. I was in class.
Eastern Standard. I think that's what that is.
Yeah, I was in class, bro, and I wanted these kind of bad, so I was on a Nike site. I'm I entered to whatever it was. It wasn't sneakers at the time. I don't think it was sneakers, but I entered it to try to win them. What's funny?
You dropped the shoes.
I entered to try to win them, and I just had to put my phone in my pocket, so I didn't know if I had them or not until the next class period. I feel like I only picked up straight Kyrie's, but Kyrie 7 All-Star. I like these at first. I don't know how I feel about them right now. Pretty much just got them because it was an all-star shoe and the all-star pack wasn't all that last year, but this is my favorite one out of the pack. So I just got them just again. All-white for you. You got a pair of these?
No. Got some Ultra Boost though.
Everybody need a pair of these, bro.
Or just a pair of all-white shoes.
All-white forces. You gotta have all-white forces.
I don't have any all-white forces.
And you barely need to wear them. Don't wear them a lot. If you get a pair, don't wear them a lot, okay?
They're not beaters. They're just something you wear if you ain't got nothing to wear, right?
Yeah. Like Devin said, they're for people who don't know how to dress. So I guess I don't know how to dress, right?
No.
I don't?
That's not how it works. Ooh.
Now, these are a personal favorite, bro. You know the story, man.
No, you tell them the story.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a good part of my past, but I had the fake version of these in high school. They was pretty bad. This part right here, it was high.
But it was kind of dull too. It's a dull gray.
Okay, you didn't have to say that. But it was really bad. But I wanted them real bad, but they wasn't out yet. And then we had this site that we used to use.
MK Hip Hop.
Yeah, MK Hip Hop.
No free ads.
Yeah, MK Hip Hop. They had them, so I ordered them. And then they came in time, but they came too soon, before the shoes even out. So my friend, my cousin Devin, he got a joke where he said I had the shoes before LeBron had them. It's pretty funny in our group, but yeah, this is my third, I had that first fake pair, and I had the real pair, and then this is my other real pair, because I hooped in the other ones and messed them up pretty bad. That's one of my favorite shoes. I got these Kyrie 1 Yeezy inspired.
You gotta do it. Easy. Just jump there.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I only wore this shoe one time, probably. I like this shoe a lot. I remember the day I bought it. And they got the gold instead of the freaking platinum, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Do that make it better or track?
I think it makes it better. Wait, so someone customized those, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And this is the Kyrie 6 Yeezys, the pure platinums. What is the pure platinum line?
Why are you asking me?
Yeah, the pure platinums. But they got that, can you see it on there?
Oh, yeah.
They got that pearly, white.
That's nice. Like a hand.
the Kyrie 6, people said they look like Yeezy, so like they was on Nike ID, everybody was making Yeezy colorways. So you know I had to hop on it. And I had the black ones too.
Now, I black one got a bag thing too?
No, I could have used it. I didn't want to use it. I dyed the soles green too, bro. And then I put the gold on here. Mm-hmm. I couldn't do it. I tried to do it on those with the silver lace tips, but it wasn't working, so I just said F it. And I got these.
The Krabby Patties.
What?
Mr. Krabs.
Oh, my fault.
Yeah, the Mr. Krabs. Like, I love SpongeBob, bro. Like, every time I come to my mama's house, I put it on SpongeBob, I watch it. So when this pack came out, I had to make sure I got it. And, like, this probably, I'm not even gonna lie, looking at them right now, I don't see them a lot. Dude, this, is this the best colorway you think?
Best colorway over the
SpongeBob?
Over the Planktons?
Planktons. Oh, yeah, those.
But these are my official colorway. Yeah, probably, yeah. Not us, but oh yeah, you're right, yeah.
The Planktons, I got these for Christmas from my brother. Like, I literally didn't know he was gonna give me anything for Christmas, for one. Then he showed up and got me these, like, custom SpongeBob. Yeah, they got the Chum Bucket thing, they got Karen.
Crazy Karen. Got Plankton squished on it, Chum Bucket. Hey, if you want him to design you some shoes, man, hit him up. Link in the description below.
I think I only wore those once. Taco PE, Kyrie. I don't know if you can see, but it's like 3M for the big Nike swoosh.
You ain't saying nothing but a word.
It's 3M for the Nike swoosh, and this Taco, not a freaking.
Now you do that.
Yeah, like this is not like a freaking taco that you eat. This from Taco from Odd Future.
Oh, Taco Fall.
Taco from Odd Future. He recently changed his name to his normal name, but
what's his normal name?
Yeah, but like, dude, when these came out, bro, I remember he wore them. They had the, he was on the Celtics, bro. They wore the white jerseys, bro. Kyrie just makes shoes look like way cleaner than what they actually are. This the first freaking Nike ID I ever made, even though I stole it from somebody, like, Instagram page. But once I seen them, bro, I had to make them. Like, it's the Big Bang, like the LeBrons. Mm-hmm. I made the lace tips yellow. Like, this is a shoe I never, like, let go. It's like, it's the first Nike ID it hold, like, special freaking man. And my favorite shoe that I own is these, bro, is right here. Like, look at this shoe, bro. Like, what make this shoe special to me, bro? Like, this the first 2K drop. So I thought, like, the 2K drop was gonna be, like, something, like, real special.
Hard to get.
Yeah, so I was, like, going crazy on 2K, dude. Like, every day, like, yo,
you had that to 20?
Like, yeah, 2K20. You had to be like a overall 98 or higher. Dude, I was a 99 here. I've never been a 99 on 2K, bro.
Was those the ones I helped?
No.
Oh.
But yeah, this is my favorite shoe. Probably because of that moment, like, I was emailing Nike and some more stuff. Cause I was like, dude, I want the shoes. Why can't I buy them? These, the Kyrie Hybrids. This is the S1. I pretty much just got these because, like, this is when I was, like, deep into the Kyrie's. And this was the USA colorway that dropped for the hybrid. I still want the black ones and the white and blue ones, but this is the only one I got. So, like, I really don't wear these at all. I kind of want to hoop in them, but then I mess up the toe part. So, I'm probably just going to keep them on ice. You know what keep on ice means, don't you?
Yeah, don't wear them. Like, dead stop. Bro, somebody said actually not wearing shoes messes them
yeah,
up.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, like to make some, the like the sole crumble and stuff.
Yeah, but I wear all my shoes. Wear your shoes, people, wear your shoes.
Yeah.
Speaking of wearing shoes, I haven't worn these. I worn these on sneakers when I came back from New York. I mean, it's not the colorway I want. I wanted either lot 1 or lot 50, but I got lot 3.
People are weird. Where you get the name lot from? Parking lot?
50 of them, that's what they call it. Dude.
Oh.
You talking about me? I'm weird?
No, not you.
But yeah, I don't know. I might sell these. I haven't worn them or nothing. I don't know how I feel about them. I like them. It's my first pair of off-whites. So what you think? I should keep them or let them go?
Depends on how much you're selling them for.
Yeah, they're worth like around like $350, $400.
How much you get them for?
$190 something.
That's making a profit.
I mean, I don't know. That's my first off-white, so I never won nothing like that, dude. That's something you gotta keep. But, yeah, anyways. These, I made these on Nike ID, like the day Kyrie got traded to the Celtics, bro.
I remember that day.
Like, I've been had the design made when, like, it was rumors he was going to the Celtics, bro. But it was, like, the trade fell through or something for a minute, so I didn't order it. Like, literally, as soon as the trade went through, I ordered these. I put his name. Just say Kyrie in there. You see
11, too.
Yeah, Kyrie 11. Like, yeah, I was a big Kyrie fan. And something about these, bro, I posted them on Instagram, right?
And they went off?
Yeah, like, I posted them at first. They weren't really, like, getting likes and stuff. But then I went to sleep and woke up. Nigga, Kyrie liked it. And he had, like, 600 likes, bro. So this shoe will always be special to me. Even though he's not with the Celtics no more. I made these right here to look like the Knicks. My Nick Kyrie Fives. I honestly thought Kyrie was going to the Knicks is why I made these, but it worked out in my favor because I made like a three pair pack. So it say CJ, but you know RJ Barrett. Mm-hmm. I was a big Duke fan when they was there. Him, RJ. Nigga, him, Zion, and Cam. So I made these for RJ. Well, I said these just for RJ. And the other, you'll see the other two in the video, so I don't know where they are right now. But I made these, I made these after the City Edition Celtic jerseys that were like green and yellow. Mm-hmm. But like, dude, translucent, I should've went that route. Like translucent, it's clean when you first get it.
But once you wear it.
Yeah, it gets clean. Yeah, like yellow and green is undefeated on shoes, bro. Like,
yeah, those are disgusting.
Yeah, like now that them two on teams, bro, freaking pack right here. KD13s is the best hoop shoe.
Oh, they're comfortable.
Yeah, it's probably the best hoop shoe from recent memory. I don't want to say the best hoop shoe ever to me, but like from recent memory.
My favorite is the Kobe 9.
Wait a minute, no. The 14s are the best hooping shoe, like right now. This year, like, the best, they slick look the best to me, too. Like, the 14s, do you like the 14s, bro?
Looking wise? Yeah. How they look? Yeah, they're fire. No, those are disgusting.
I got these for, I think Father's Day. I don't know. I didn't really want nothing. She kept asking me what I want. So I just said these. Because I was like, when the KD14s came out, dude, like, I hooped in them, dude. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. It was like hooping in heaven, bro.
Like, I'm getting a bucket on God.
These are like, right now, like this year, 2021, I don't like these as much as I used to.
Tripping.
Like when they first came out, dude, like I was crazy over these. Like, I remember he wore them. I think he wore these the game Clay scored 60. Bro. This was like the Christmas called the Sauce. Yeah, I mean, I wore these on Christmas with a little burgundy, little cardigan thing. I think I was clean, but I thought I wasn't. I had the Black History Month, blue lace tip really.
Aglet.
The blue aglet really set this shoe off, bro. Dude, like the Kyrie 2s was probably his best shoe ever.
Mm-hmm. One's nice too.
Yeah, with the, like I said, the Sauce, the KDs I just had, these came out the same year, but these was like an overseas exclusive. And I wanted them real bad, so like I bought them through some place called Kicks Crew, I think. I think I remember the date. It was like December 18th, like 2016.
Yeah.
Is it weird that I remember that?
Yeah.
For a shoe?
Very.
But yeah, this was my favorite shoe for a long time until the LeBron's came.
Yeah, that's around the time Awaken My Love came out. Yeah. And J. Cole, right? Mm-hmm.
This is probably one of the few shoes that's not Nike in here. And it's the Curry's. I had these in high school. Like, this was the first Curry colorway I ever bought. So, we was talking about shoes one day, and I just bought them again. But yeah, I had these in 2015. This was the first Curry I ever bought. And I messed them up. And I spray painted them gold.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
You was wilding on those shoes, bro.
Yeah, I just spray painted them gold. And then we was talking about shoes randomly. I just saw these again. I rebought them.
How much you rebuy them for?
Dude, it was like cheap, probably like $40.
Yeah, that's what I figured. I actually always like those shoes.
Yeah, I bought them to hoop in. I said I ain't hooping them yet.
Cause those front, the toe box get messed up pretty easily.
Another one, dude, this was my favorite shoe. The same year as the LeBrons, but the LeBrons always take over, bro. But like this shoe, dude, look at this one. This was like God tier night.
Did an aglet?
You talking about?
Yeah, different color aglet.
It's like whitish. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like this, these are like the what down pearls. Like they got the freaking 11s from these. The bottom, you see?
Mm-hmm.
And with the sixes, is the sixes on here? I think the sixes is this right here.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, this is my favorite unpearl because of the, then it got the strap and some more stuff. Since we're already on the unpearls, this the, I got these recently. Like, I always wanted these and, since like high school.
Mm-hmm.
But I never, we never really could like afford it really. I mean, I could have got these a long time ago, but you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I'm glad I finally got them. This, I like this shoe a lot. Like, when I first got them, bro, just like with the freaking, the other shoes I told you, this is my favorite shoes at the time, but like, these are like, people don't really like KDs like that, but I never, like, I always liked them for some reason. Like, ever since.
What's the best KD?
The best KD,
what else? Was that, what else? Those the fours?
The fours?
The white ones? The blue? White and blue? That was the best one.
No.
Yes.
This is the 14. Is it? I got the Bayou Boys, the Zion shoes. I think these are the Jordan 34s. They got 3M as well. It's like Bayou Boys on the back. Can you see the 3M?
A little bit. A little bit.
But yeah, you know he got drafted to New Orleans and
Bayou.
This shoe, this is clean colorway for me. Like it screams Zion, right?
Yeah. It actually does, weirdly so. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Depends on how you look at it. This another 2K colorway. This is the KD 13 Funks. Next time I hoop, I'm hooping in these, bro. But yeah, like this colorway, I liked it. I mean, it's all right. It's not the best colorway.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like when I seen that they was coming out, I had to get them. Got the Kobe 10.
Let me hoop in them. Let me hoop in them. Right. Are you hooping them? Oh, never mind.
I haven't hooped in them yet.
You was planning on hooping them?
I don't know. Like, I was going to hoop in them, but like, every time I'm finna hoop and shit, I do this. I don't know, I just, like, you know, I'm kind of like 50% right now, so I don't know.
Let me hoop in them.
All right, I don't want to risk getting hurt in a shoe that I don't freaking know.
Nah, I feel you.
So, yeah. These, I saw, like, it was a pretty Kobe. He was shooting around in these, bro.
Mm-hmm.
It was just, like, random days. Shoes just, like, hit me. I was like, dang, I had to get them. And that was, it happened recently, bro, with these.
D-Lo's hooping them.
These was the Kyrie 2 Brotherhoods, but I asked my brother, the same way I did the Planktons, I asked if he can do
UK.
Put UK on them, because Tyler Ulysses had this exact shoe with UK on it. I thought it was like dumb clean, so I asked if he can do it. And it's the finished product.
BBN. Hey, isn't that kind of violating though? Slick.
Slick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good. I didn't wear these a lot at all.
I wore them more than you.
I told y'all about the RJ Barry ones, the Knicks. This is the Hawks when they were still this color.
Oh my God.
Yeah, this when they were still this color, I got these. I made them after Cam Reddish. On the inside, I put Cam Found. Yeah, I was big on Duke that year when they had Zion, RJ, and Cam Reddish.
Now that I noticed, why you make those Trey Jones shoes then? Those Spurs.
He was still in Duke.
Oh, still could have made him more.
Nigga, how was I gonna know where he's gonna get drafted 2 years later? But yeah, like, dude, like, Dude, I haven't wore these yet.
Well, it's bleeding, too.
I wore these one time. I wore them to the gym. Literally one time. And it's, like, bleeding through like crazy, bro. That's why I said translucent. If you want to make something with translucent, bro, that's not the best look, bro.
That bleeding kind of look cool, though.
Think so?
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, I got these LeBron 18s, 1 through 9. I got it, like, exclusive access or something. I mean, these, they sat. But I wanted these. Like I didn't care if they sat, sold out, or nothing. I wanted them because of, like, all the colors. But I like colorful shoes, bro. And these was a shoe that I wanted. And they had the lace lock thing, too. Like, oh, yeah. To watch the toes. This shoe is just clean. Oh, my God. Like, look at this. Do it look clean on camera?
Mm-hmm.
This is a clean shoe. But the LeBron 18s, like, comfort-wise, like, hooping and all that, that's not, they're not it. And this is the white version of the what the Kyrie 2s. This is the ones that came out in the States, I think. But I stopped, I used to wear these a lot, but I stopped wearing them because they was getting dirty. Now that I'm looking at them, I kind of want to wear them right now. These, the Squidward Kyrie 5s. This was my favorite from the pack at a point, like before they came out. But then when they actually came out, they just didn't hit the same like the pictures, but they still a clean colorway. That whole pack was crazy. They had the KD 12 All-Stars. He didn't even play that year, I think. These are Don C, KD 12s. I like these a lot. I got them to hoop in. I hooped in them once. They literally started tearing on the side.
Let me see. Where at? I don't see it.
Right here, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Like that. Like, literally, after one time hooping in them. So, I ain't hooped in them since then, but I was comfortable and everything. I need to hoop in them again. These, bro. Oh, Lord. The LeBron 17s was a special, special shoe to me, man. Some, like, when I was working at, Walmart, so I was down bad. Yeah, I was working at Walmart, bro. And, like, I was known as the dude that had a lot of shoes, and they said, like, this dude said these was the best shoes I had. Like, literally, somebody, I was wearing a shoe one day, and, like, it was the dude that said these were my best shoes, and somebody else, they was walking together, and she was like, oh, I like your shoes. And he was like, oh, did you see the ones he had on the other day? He was talking about these.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So I don't know why, but that just made these shoes even more special to me, bro. Like, dude, he a normal nigga, bro.
Yeah, that's how I figured. He was like a normal nigga that said, dang, I'm the best shoe you got, bro.
But yeah, like, I always liked them, bro. They're the Monstars. And I got these for $148 on Nike.
Mm.
It's just certain things about different shoes that I remember.
Yeah.
Like these right here, I wore these and they was doing a freaking Pie Manager Day. Like literally, one of them got pie and literally like the white stuff like just slashed on these. But I like these, bro, because they like the Phoenix Suns.
I see it.
You see it?
Yeah, I see the pie.
Yeah, it still got some pie.
Yeah, it still got the pie.
It still got some pie, man. But I like these. They look like the Phoenix Suns, and this was another 2K exclusive shoe. I tried to get all of them. I think the only ones I don't got is like the BB Adapts, and I had the Kobe's. I don't even want to speak on that. Oh, moment of silence. R.I.P. to Kobe. The Kobe All-Stars.
Sheesh.
Or as Kiana call them, the pizza shoes. She said they like pizza.
What pizza are she? What is she eating?
Yeah, she said he's like pizza. But this is my second time having this shoe, right?
Yeah, for sure. Second I used to wear them a lot in high school.
You used to wear my shoes? That's why they mess up now.
Dude, they're not the same ones.
But yeah, these, I stopped wearing these because of this. I mean, I know it can be fixed. But Kobe's are like special. Like, they special now. Everybody know what happened, so. This shoe is gonna stay with me forever. Like, I bought these, I think it was like December 2019.
Mm-hmm.
It was like December or January, like before he passed, and I was trying to get the Kobe 8, the snake skin, which was the Christmas ones.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a screenshot on my phone. It was literally 150. And then Kobe passed, and now they, you know, they
crazy.
They raised the price for literally no reason.
Bro, the ones you talking about, the snake skin ones? They got like spikes coming out of them? Yeah.
I'm still gonna get them. These, I got these from the mall. This was like, for those who don't know, I got two kids, so like we had like income tax. It was income tax season. I was just at the mall just buying stuff. So I bought these, and they was like the C edition from the Warriors. And those jerseys was like the cleanest jerseys mm-hmm. at the time. They should start back wearing those, but dude, I something happened. I don't know. I tried to return them. And the niggas, like, literally, dude, they was like, the bottom was brand new. Probably like, dude, it wasn't nothing on the bottom, but the nigga said, but the nigga said that they was like worn.
You didn't wear them?
Like, I literally
bean.
Tried
keep
to,
it a bean.
I wore them to work, actually. Like, literally, work the shift in them. But, bro, like, nigga, they still look brand new. I cleaned them and some of those. I tried to take them back. I don't know why I was trying to take them back.
I like the dope.
That nigga, he was not going on.
My bad, I done messed up the video. My bad. Hold
on. You good? What you
give my review on it, because he really kind of, you know.
Okay, what you got to say? What you got to say?
Now, these right here?
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't dare hooping these.
Why not?
It's like, it's...
But bro, in the shoe's defense, you were like a size 20.
I swear a size 12.
No, a 13.
Just no, get up. It's, no.
Get up.
I got these made by Andrew TL. I don't know. If you like in the sneaker community, you probably know who he is.
He's popular.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Like, customized shoes ain't the wave no more, bro. I mean, people still do it, but it was like big at a point. Like, but like all the Nike signs are different color, just like the PG2 PlayStations.
Mm-hmm.
But like I told you, I was deep in that Kyrie stuff, so I asked him to make these. I think that was like $200, and this part, it glowed in the dark. It glowed blue.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't really wear them a lot, cause on it, like he painted the inside too, so it like go on my socks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this like goat. It's like goat tier in my
show
shoe.
Them the tongue. Not the tongue, the strap.
Strap.
Yeah.
The strap got all the PlayStation little buttons.
That's crazy.
Yeah, even right here got the...
That's crazy.
Yeah, this shoe, like, dude is goated with the customs. Like, he made some Joker ones for me. Like, if I can go back to 2019 and slap me before
you
I...
sold them?
Yeah.
I remember them too.
And dude, I sold them for some LeBrons that I don't even have no more, that I could have got for like $40
probably. Oh Lord.
Yeah, these the ones you went crazy for me on, bro.
I was carrying, dude. Your dude was good. That level guard you had was actually pretty good.
Yeah, I got these on 2K as well. This is the playoff. I think that the playoff colorway. But yeah, he ended up wearing these mugs in the bubble, bro, so. But like, they look better on the pictures, bro. They clean in person still, like the zebra print in the bottom. Yeah, they look better on pictures, bro. Got the sandy cheeks, man.
I like those the most. They're not the best colorway, but I like them the most. I don't know why.
Yeah, like, I told y'all, that SpongeBob pack I was on, I got
This
is a pretty clean color. It got her flower, bro.
Yeah, that's why I like it. It's simple, bro.
You got this.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is... Dude, Nike went crazy on this pack. Yes, sir. Media days. LeBron 7. I think this... I know he wore these on media day. I think this like the first Laker colorway they dropped for him, bro.
Mm-hmm.
I know this, like, this shoelace right here go on the yellow shoe and they don't go on there.
You just slushed them.
Uh-huh. It just flows better, bro.
Yeah, I think that would look weird.
Yeah, it just make the shoe better. I wore them on my birthday when I turned 23. I wore these this year on my birthday, but this was the, it was black. It was white and black. You know.
You customized them?
No, I did. Oh. But yeah, like it's starting to peel, as you can see. I might just peel it all the way off, bro. Make it go back black. Because he said he used a different type of paint, bro. Dude, like, it, oh my God, dude.
It's been bad.
Yeah, D, I'm going to have to steal off on you on this. If I peel them off and they go back to white, black, and yellow, Cody, I'm telling you, I'm going to buy this Lakers shirt. It's black and mm-hmm. yellow. Mm-hmm. And when I wear that on my mom, ain't nobody in here gonna stop it. And if I get hate on somebody, they these, bro. He wore these on Christmas, brother. The concepts, I actually hit for these on sneakers, bro. That purple, I can't explain it, bro. It's like a freaking... I can't explain it, but you see it, bro. And then, bro, this is just like a... Concepts and Nike always go crazy together.
Let me see the eyes in the back.
Kobe 9s, like...
Those are the best hoopers you ever hooped in.
Yeah, they go to here. Like, I got into Kobe Hot Tops. Reason I never played them until last year. This was the first ones I bought. Like, dude, they go crazy. Like, they comfortable, bro. They protective. Mm-hmm. They just everything. Like they got grip. Like, this is the best grip system probably.
Ever.
Yeah. This is probably the best Nike grip system. I know they put it on the PG5s. Got the Christmas colorway too.
Those are disgusting.
Got the Christmas colorway too. Yeah, this, like out of all the Kobe 9s, I got these probably the ones I had the most buggies in. You wanna, you know, is it weird that I know that one?
What?
Did I know I got the most buggies in these?
Nah, not that weird. Kinda though.
These.
Those are the ones I hooped in.
You hooped in these?
Mm-hmm. Or the black ones? The black and white ones?
I don't got no black and white.
I hope in some pair.
Was it those? It had to be these.
Nah, I think it was those. Remember? Because I had them sweats on.
I don't remember, but yeah, this is the All-Star ones, bro. I got these like $200. They look like they in like great condition, bro. Dude, this whole pack, like the whole gumbo pack, was crazy, dude. And I got all the cards and everything.
What, those right there?
Yeah. Like these, bro, like another sad story from my past. Had the fake version of these too.
But that version was good, right?
Yeah, it don't matter, it was still fake, but I had the fake version of these. Like literally, as I got older, I started making my own money. I told myself every shoe I had that was fake, I'm gonna recop the real ones. So I've been doing a pretty good job with that. Y'all see. But yeah, this one of the best KDs ever released. Did you agree, bro?
Ever?
Yeah. Dude, the gumbo pack is like undefeated.
Those Kobe's was disgusting. I like the Kobe's the most.
Yeah. And these right here. This is probably the shoe I spent the most money on.
400?
Yeah, 400. But I had to get them, brother. Dude, the South Beach LeBrons, bro. This is like a shoe you never thought you would have. Like, bro, but they freaking retro them, bro. Dude, this shoe got me losing my damn mind right now. But, bro, this is one of the best shoes. Like, this is probably LeBron's best shoe ever. No, never. It's the what the MVP is, but
yeah.
I don't have those, so.
You gotta cop them, bro.
Yeah, I had the fake versions of them, but. They gonna get got. And I got these, the Abominable Snowman Kyrie 2s. I remember he wore these on Christmas.
They know some good days, man.
Yeah, they got toe up that year. I remember where I was at when I bought these. I was at Terrell's house, on top of their bed.
Yeah, we used to go to Terrell's house a lot. Definitely you.
Okay, y'all. Don't fault me.
But I had the fake versions of these, too. It was... They wasn't that bad, but I remember, like, the shoestrings was, like, dark red. Mm-hmm. and this dude, we used to play at the park all the time. This dude had like on the real one, he was like a younger dude, so I knew it was gonna work, this plan. So like, hey bro, you wanna sell those shoestrings? They caught him off guard. He's like, yeah, I would. I think I would spend like $10 for them. So I can make the shoestrings the actual color, because it was like three dudes at the school that had these already.
Mm-hmm.
And I had the favorite, so I'm trying to make mine look as real as possible. Like, mine didn't have the 3M on the tongue or nothing, but none of that matters now, right?
Dude, yes. You know what's even more funny about that? You was in the class when Kyron had his on.
Yeah, I was trying to, I kept high on my feet, like, under the table. But dude, you wanna know something funny about the shoestring thing?
What?
Like, after I gave him the money and everything, mm-hmm. bro, he was like, oh, yeah, I got a lot of shoestrings.
Yeah, I got a lot of shoestrings if you want them.
Nigga, I do not care about your damn shoestrings. You never knew that, bro?
No, I remember you got them, but I didn't know how you got them.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, appreciate you, bro. He was like, yeah, bro, I got a lot of shoestrings. I got black. Dude, I don't care, man. These right here, I had these in 11th grade, I think. My brother D bought them for me for school.
Yeah,
I messed them up pretty bad. Like, we used to play outside all the time. I wore them to the park, hooped in them out there, and they got pretty bad. So I had to make sure I recopped them, because this is one of the, like, this colorway is crazy to me, dude. Mango, like, these colors don't, you don't expect to see this color on the shoe together.
I remember that day.
But now that you see it on the shoe together, it's like, just.
Yeah, I remember when he copped them, you know, East Bay. I just specifically remember seeing the photos. Of it. Yeah.
And these, he hit the three on, it wasn't a three, he hit the game winner against the Warriors on Christmas Day, and these, I could have, like, I don't know why, but I don't like this shoe a lot. You know, like, I kind of want to sell it or something, do a giveaway or something. But I could have got the Dornbecker Kyrie 2s. I won two bids at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, I could have like either got these or the Dornbeckers, but I chose these because like mostly because he hit the shot in them.
Those are clean though. You got that samurai shirt with him.
Was dumb dusty, bro.
I like that shirt, dude.
And I went to that school for nothing. I was dumb dusty. Y'all should have stayed home.
Dude, I like that shirt so much. I drew that dude on the shirt.
Yeah, these, like these right here, I remember my friend Brandon, he had them, bro. He had like the Miami Heat sweatshirt that like went with it. Like, he was clean that day. He was dumb. And I saw these was cheap. Probably like the $40 range. I'ma just bet, like every shoe I got for cheap, I'ma base it around $40.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Bro, I saw these, I just wanted them again. The graffiti, the bottle of
them. Those are clean. I thought they was clean too. I like that.
The pine green ones. I got these from the mall, which is surprising because I came out a few days before, like, I went up there. I was like, do y'all got these in the 11? So, you know what, we do. So, I couldn't turn it down, I bought them. And I think this is the only pair of ones I got. Yeah, the only pair of ones I got. I need to get some more ones. I'm really not
that much. What's the best?
Really not that much into Jordans like that, but I'm starting to get more into them, so I need to cop some more ones. Got the, 1 through 16, what the LeBron,
16.
Mm-hmm. But I remember these was like on 2K. But that's when 2K was, God, that was 2K19.
Mm-hmm. That was God tier, right?
Good days of 2K.
Facts.
Bro. This shoe, like, I like this gold part right here the most of this shoe.
Let me see it.
Like, when I saw this shoe was coming, I didn't think, like, I would own them. Like, this was that type of shoe. Yeah, as the people that know me, the dude that's recording this video, Cody, his favorite player, Chris Paul.
Mm-hmm.
So me and him being as close as we are, we was and are, like I grew a love for Chris Paul too, and his shoes was comfortable. Like this specific pair. I don't know if these are the sixes, but yeah, these was comfortable. I remember our friend Anthony had this colorway right here.
Mm-hmm.
Like one day we was just in like the Xbox party talking about Chris Pauls, and I just searched them up. I got these for.
Are you on?
It was like 50.
Mm-hmm.
They wasn't budging.
Ain't that the age though?
Yeah, this is the age.
Yeah.
The Clippers. But we hate the Clippers around here. Got the Hardwood Classic, LeBron 8s. The plan, these wasn't even in my freaking plan. Like, I tried to get the UNC 4s because they came out on the same day as these.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't get neither one of them on sneakers. But this place called Rock City Kicks where we live, they had these in the store, so I just went to the store and got them. Definitely don't regret it, but I'm going to call these the Knicks because I wear mostly Knicks stuff with this. Like, this shoe was literally in New York.
I
stepped foot in New York.
You did? That's crazy.
I had these Easter candy dunks. I only got these. I know this is a girl colorway, women's colorway, but my wife counted. She had them, and she wanted to match. So I like colorful stuff, so I got them too. It's a pretty cool colorway. I got these on the Oral Aqua. Kyrie 6s, I might hoop in these. They really just be sitting in the closet. Dude, you know Devin is the reason I got these.
He gave you them?
No, Kana, she...
Oh, yeah, you know, she asked
Devin
him.
Coach, yeah, she asked Devin, like, what type of shoes I've like, mm-hmm. been talking about or something. Like, I just sent him a picture of these. Because they look clean in the picture, and he said these. I mean, they clean, but they ain't what I wanted.
You could have got something good.
They clean, though. Like, they actually, like, dumb clean. Like, this blue is crazy. Now, these right here, these are special to me. I'll call these the championship LeBron 18. They won a ring in the bubble.
Mm-hmm.
This is what he had on, bro. I got exclusive access. Literally, my first week at my new job, bro. Like, my first check that I got from there,
mm-hmm.
I got these. Dude, that was a bad week for me. It was a bad but good week. It was good for shoes wise, but it was bad for life wise. Literally, I got like 3 pairs of shoes in one day.
Oh, I remember that day.
Yeah, but I definitely don't regret any of it. Like, this orange is God tier. Best LeBron 18 colorway. The reason I'm shaking my head, y'all, is because I had to fake pair of these too. But like I said, does any of that matter now?
It does. It definitely does.
But yeah, the pair that I had in freaking high school was bad. Like these lines right here was literally going through this D. It's not supposed to be.
They wasn't that bad. All you had to do was cut that part out.
I wasn't finna do all that. But yeah, this colorway is God tier. Like this, I probably spent like $340 on these. But like I said, every shoe that I had that was fake, I'm recopping it real quick. And this is a beautiful shoe. Like if you see this shoe with the 3M, you'll be going crazy. Kyrie 1 Dreams. I got these for like $60 on Macari. I remember he wore these. This was his first shoe, the first shoe he ever wore, like his first signature shoe.
Mm-hmm.
He wore them against the Knicks. That was a good times, bro. He was still in high school and everything, bro.
You remember that shoe that LeBron wore? Was the Kyrie ones? Was that it? Was some all red ones?
Yeah, they were all red ones.
Yeah.
And then this year they did the KD pack with the KDs, and they made the KDs into this colorway. This, I think the KDs look better than the Kyries, honestly. What'd you think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I just think those Dreams were dumb clean though when they first came out.
Yeah. But I think as of right now, until the LeBron 19s come out, KD got the best looking signature shoe. This is my favorite shoe.
Why Giannis shoe?
And this is my favorite shoe when they, like this colorway.
Mm-hmm.
When I first got them, like, I was in love with these, bro. Like, I set them, like, it was on the box over there, and, like, my bed was, like, over here, and I used, like, the way I sleep, they was in my view when I sleep. Mm-hmm. Now, these, bro, these are special.
Mm-hmm.
Kobe 6 Grinches. I think I spent a lot to get these, but does that matter?
Yes. Hey, do the Grinch impersonation, bro. All
right, Max.
Dude, you embarrassing me. And I fell for it.
Those are clean, though.
But yeah, this is the best Kobe colorway ever.
Ever?
Ever.
Okay.
Dude, look at this shoe, bro.
That was always cheap on 2K.
I don't even think they're on 2K anymore.
Yes, they are. Unless niggas made them. A lot of niggas be having them on.
Them the Kobe 11.
Oh.
Terrell got them too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was looking for these. They don't have them on there, but. This. Dang, I want to say this is my favorite shoe I got. This, I'm not going to say they're my favorite shoe. They're my most special shoe that I own. Got the Watch the Throne 16s. I think this was like the first shoe they did, like Team LeBron and all that. This is what he wore. I knew I was copping one once I seen this right here.
That little gold look.
Yeah. Wasn't nothing stopping
me. Lace lock.
These, bro. And then this Watch the Throne. It's a beautiful shoe, dude. Even though it's black, it's still beautiful. And now we move on to the best colorway from the SpongeBob pack. And this is SpongeBob.
Is it the best?
Yes.
Okay. Patrick's is pretty clean.
Yeah, Patrick's is clean, but SpongeBob's, they just different, bro.
Yeah.
But like, I got a picture. Like, I took these at the gym.
You good?
Look at the shoe string, bro.
It's because they get attached to Velcro.
But yeah. I had a picture I took of them when I was at the gym, and that made this my favorite color. The KD6s.
Those are the best KDs.
Yeah, like this, when it come to what goes wrong, like, they did these perfectly, bro.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They got the Unpearls, the Easters,
the Gumbos.
They got everything. Like, they did these perfectly. Like, this is a perfect weapon, bro.
Yeah, it is.
And I especially like how they did green and blue. Like, the green and blue just...
Mm-hmm.
These are what, the KD7s? Like, the best part about these is this strap, literally.
You got some Unpearl strap.
Yeah. Like this.
That, what was that strap on? One on the left, right?
Oh, something. The All-Stars.
Mm.
Yeah. From these, this the best shoe out of what the, like, the best shoe of this colorway.
Mm-hmm.
But as you all know, I had the fake versions of these two. I actually had two.
Ooh, I forgot about the first one.
Yeah, the first one was like I need my ass whooped.
Those were horrible.
Yeah, they was that bad.
And they were too big.
Yeah, like I ordered a size 11. They was like a size
13. Yeah.
I didn't wear them enough. I threw them away. Like in the big green trash can. I was like, but then I ordered a second pair. That was kind of,
that was good. This is a toe box was small.
Yeah, the toe box was like thin. But like I said, every shoe I had that was fake, I got these bad boys. I had to get the room. So, but they like translucent, man. So, translucent is the best looking thing about a shoe, but over time it just looked the worst, man.
Like them Bellairs.
These right here, bro. I remember looking at these in class, bro. I honestly never thought I had this shit.
Those are crazy. Was your lights real fast? Was your light off real fast?
Nah.
Okay.
You know, they know what they look like.
Okay.
They watching the sneaker video, they should.
Yeah.
But I got these senior year, bro. Like, the box made this All-Star pack better, too. And then the bottoms is clean. And then this waistline. But just everything about the gumbo package. I got these made by the Andrew TL dude too.
Peeling.
Yeah, but these they peeling, so I don't wear them at all. Like they peeling, but Kyrie, like he when he was still with Cleveland, he wore a red, like they was red and gold, mm-hmm. like this. So I asked, since he went to the Celtics, I asked for green and gold. But like this was the time to shine pair, so he painted it black, but after wearing them, he went back to the time to shine. Colorful stuff, so. I want to say this is a bad custom. It's not a bad custom, it's just, it's messed up. The red, what the LeBron 17s. These not as special, like, looking wise as the purple ones.
Mm-mm. They look definitely better than the purple ones.
No, I'm tripping. They clean, though. I gotta get a bucket in them, bro.
They just look like all red.
Yeah, these, they are crazy, though. All red, LeBron with the 17. I should start wearing that more. And this shoe right here, this is the shoe that started it for me, like with the Nike basketball stuff. And I got these from Hibbett Sports. I remember they like came with the newspaper, mm-hmm. Area 72 stuff. That was a good All-Star year too.
Facts.
But Nike, they don't go as deep as they used to, bro. It is like, oh, they gonna buy it anyway. That's just what DC think. But
yeah,
this is a shoe that started all for me. This is my second pair of these. Like, I trashed the first one. I hooped in them. They had, like they had a hole in the bottom. It was just, man, since that was a shoe that started all, I had to recop them. I like the freaking, the alien color. Dude, this shoe is beautiful, man. Kyrie 2 calves. Remember he did that little dance in them, bro?
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful shoe too. Like the calves colors.
That's a nice color, too.
Yeah. Bro, and then it's like you see the navy blue and then the yellow. Mm-hmm. And then you see this little red right here. That's crazy. These are special, man. The Bruce Lee Kyrie 3s. I got these before they came out too. I got them from this place called Rare, New York. I guess they didn't think that they was gonna be like as exclusive as they was. They sold them for $190. So if you see something like that and you like scared, like you don't know, like if this shoe sell out, would I be able to get it for the price like $190 afterwards? So like, nah, I'ma just buy it before they come out for the $190. You know? Luckily, they still here with me. LeBron 16, Superman, whatever you want to call them. Looking at them right now, I don't like these at all no more, bro.
Jump, bro. Those are disgusting.
I mean, I don't wear these at all, bro. Like, I might sell them. Man, I remember I bought these, like, they was literally 170. I got these made by my brother when Kyrie went to the Celtics as well. Yeah, he was like really just testing to see if he could even do stuff on shoes like this.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, this what it turned out to be. These right here is in the same Chris Pauls, but this just not the artisan edition.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when I got those KD 5 All-Stars, my brother Cody, he got these.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like I said, Cody, he got these when we... Yeah, when I got those KD 5 All-Stars, my brother Cody, he got these.
Mm-hmm.
Like, these was a big part of our teenage years, I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like the green apple freaking color and then the Tar Heel color. Like, mm-hmm. We had this Carolina shirt.
Yep. That was a fit we both wore.
Yeah. I mean, you was brothers, dude.
That was a clean fit, though.
Yeah, and then, like, we was talking about, I got these for $40. A size 12, but I wear 11, but I can fit them double up the socks. I got these Man, I had these mostly for memories. What's these called? Peach creams. It's my second time having these. I had these. I remember they came out August 28th. The first time I had them, I got them for my birthday. I know they came out like August 28th that year, I think. It's crazy that I remember that. But
it's probably because it's very close to your birthday.
Yeah, I think I got a picture of the box where the box got 828 written on it. Mm-hmm. I think that's why. But like the first time I had them, I traded them for the KD7 Easy Monies, which was probably robbery on the other dude end. But that was like a time like where shoes was like important. So you want to like I traded these to make it look like I had these and plus the shoes I traded them for. But yeah, that was a bad trade on my end, so I had to get them back. And now this shoe ain't never going nowhere. Like, I love this color, like the freaking the peach colors. And these this the third pair of the this is Zion Williamson pair because he on the Pelicans. I made it the navy blue, the red, and the gold to match the Pelicans jersey. Yeah, I put the gold sprinkles on there.
The gold aglet too.
Yeah, I wore these, but I don't remember wearing them. I want to hoop in them.
Did you paint the aglet? Really like, oh, okay.
Yeah. At the Kyrie 7 Weathermans, this was a part of the KD pack, which was the with the KD Dreams I showed you earlier. Like, this shoe is like, hey, I got a few like Celtic shirts, so every time I wear a Celtic shirt, these I throw these on. I got these for Christmas from my wife, and she got me the jersey as well, the KD jersey.
Those look like the other ones you had.
Yeah, yeah, they're the same color, but like this shoe, it's not like crazy or nothing, but it's just the hardwood classic, like the jersey. So I like KD line, I like the 13, so I just had to get these. I need to pull that outfit out, by the way.
You
only got one of these right now. I only got one of these right now. And I left them at home, but this is the Sylvester versus Tweety LeBron 18 Lows for the Space Jam movie. Mm. And with this is the Sylvester one. I had left the Tweety one at home.
Sylvester Stallone?
Yeah.
You said what?
You
I beat dude down on my mama.
Yeah, the KD, this the pair, this the KD 14s. This the first pair I had. I hooped in them. Like, I see why KD be getting his buckets, bro.
I see why he lost them in the game, too.
He did that in them KDs, but yeah, this KD 14s is like easily the best looking and best feeling shoe this year until the LeBron 19s come. The LeBron 19s are beautiful. These are the Game 7. This not the official Game 7s, but these are the Nike ID versions. This shoe was special to me because, you know, he hit the shot of all shots for the Cavs that year. And, like, every time I hoop in this shoe, I go crazy. So, that's another plus for me. Black and gold is
easy.
Yeah, black and gold is it. That's it. Okay, these right here. I know y'all probably, but these Childish Gambino is my favorite artist ever to ever walk this earth. I don't care who you put in front of, but Childish Gambino is my favorite artist ever. It was around the time I just probably listened to his music heavy. And I remember he had a line with Adidas. So I searched it up and these was like $90. So I said, why not? It's Childish Gambino. So I just got them. But my son, he was eating around them and he got ketchup on it.
Dang.
Man, that's easy to clean out. CJ, I'm gonna get you. This the City Edition Part 2 for the KD10s. Since I had the blue ones, when I saw that these was coming out, I had to get them. Since dude didn't let me return them anyways. But yeah, this one, I like this color a lot. I like colors like this, like colors that's different that you don't normally see on a shoe every day. like colors like that, so I made sure I had to get these. And they also went with those clean Warrior jerseys. Okay, I got a quick story about these right here. Like when they revealed the pack or something, like this part of the shoe was, they only showed like this part of the shoe, so I didn't think it was coming out. So I reached out to this dude. What's his name? I think he go by the Concept Commission on Instagram. I reached out to that nigga about see if he can make these for me, cause I didn't think that was coming out. So the nigga was like, yeah, all that. He took the money, all that. I sent him the shoes. And the nigga stopped responding, so I had to blow him up and all that. This nigga talking about, sorry, bro, a family member passed away. I'm gonna get it out to you though. Dude, that was like 3 years ago.
Oh Lord, he finessed.
But it don't matter. The shoes are right here.
No, it does matter. He finessed.
But if the shoes right here, did I really get finessed?
Yes, you got finessed.
Yeah, that nigga.
Oh, this scum of this world.
I should have said, never mind. I'm not gonna say what I want to say. But this colorway, I love this colorway when it first came out, bro. Like, I mean, he wore these the first game. His first game as a Brooklyn Net, bro. He went crazy. He dropped 50. Mm. So this shoe, it holds special value. You want these, bro?
Yeah.
They not good.
I hooked them. They weren't that bad.
Well, I got them on my car to sell, so if somebody buy them, they buy them, but they don't.
Okay.
But yeah, these are what the Kobe 9s. They not in good condition. I think I slick got finesse for these. They look better on the pictures, bro. Like, y'all hear that?
I don't think they could tell, though, off hearing it. They gotta feel it. Because, yeah, it does feel bad, yeah.
Yeah, like...
like, your hand's sliding right off of it.
Yeah, I can't hoop in these, so like, these are literally worthless, but they are what the Kobe's. Amount of buggers I would have gotten, like, just looking at this shoe, dude, I would have went crazy in them. Patrick. At first, I'm not gonna lie, these was the best looking from the pack to me because of the pink and green and just.
And purple.
God, that's. Like, I like vibrant, I like being loud. Like, I'm not a loud person talking wise, but like, shoe wise, I like to be loud. I got the Kyrie 7 concepts.
Let me see that back in time.
I actually got these from this guy named Dion Point. He worked for, I think he worked for Concepts. I'm not sure. But one of our friends is named Jeffrey. Like under one of Dion Point posts, he was like, tagged a Kyrie fan that didn't get the shoe. And he tagged me under there, and then I messaged him, and he sent me these, and it came with the special box and everything. So shout out to them, too.
That was free?
I had to pay for them. Right? But, like, the special box was sold out on the website. But I went through him, and I got the special box. And I got the PG5. I tried to make them at, like, the Cinnamon Toast Crunch Kyrie's. But I didn't know what I was doing with like the paint splatter, so it looks.
It's not that bad from a distance, but when you get close.
Yeah, from.
Don't let it out on the camera. Okay, the back would come bad.
Yeah, like it's some spots that's just terrible. Like.
Yeah. You used the toothbrush?
Yeah, I was flicking it, man. I haven't worn them yet, because I don't know why. I might hoop in these, but yeah, I made them to look like the Kyrie for the Cinnamon Toast Crunches. So I might sell these too, so if you want these, let me know in the comments. These are from the year when the Zion and all them was there at Duke, so this pair is special to me too, and I got exclusive access to them. Sneakers, I remember I was at the hospital that I was sick, and I got exclusive access to them, and I bought them. So this shoe ain't never going nowhere. Shout out to Duke. This shoe, I bought these when I was a senior in high school. Like, when I was seeing pictures of these, like, before they came out, I was telling... You remember me telling you if I don't get these, I was gonna cry?
No.
Well, yeah, that's how I feel. I feel like if I didn't get these, I was gonna cry. Not actually gonna cry.
They gold side. Clean.
Yeah, that's just how I feel, bro. Like, that's how much I wanted this shoe. Like, I literally paid resale for this for no reason, because literally Josh and Terrence didn't have them. And we, like, me and Josh wore them on the same day, and I paid, I pre-ordered them. So.
Oh, you just wanted to make sure you got them.
Yeah.
And then you did too much. Because you would have got it anyway.
And then these, I made these to look like the Kobe 5 preludes. I put, I don't know if you can see, but it say Kobe on the tongue. Mm-hmm. Then on the back, it say rest easy, Kobe Bean. I was going through a little PG-5 stage.
I got me some PGs.
Because they got the bottom like the Kobe 9s. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to lie. I played in some PG-5s for one day. Like,
they hurt my feet.
Yeah, we was hooping for some hours that day. Like, literally, my heel was hurting for like some months, bro.
It hurt my feet, too.
But these right here.
That's the best shoe in your collection.
I wouldn't say that. But the LeBron, all this Area 72s, like, this is a beautiful shoe. I remember my friend DeMarco, he had them. I wanted them, but I didn't have the money to get them. But now I got them. Like, this is like my third pair of these. But I had a size 10, 10 and a half, and 11. I think this is the 10 and a half, and I sold the other two. Got the KD 11 EYBLs. I remember when I bought these. Not a lot of y'all. I bought these in the Thunderstruck KD4s. But like a few days later, like me and my wife, our car got towed. Cause like we was late on the car note or whatever. So basically these shoes is the reason why that car got towed. I mean, but does that matter now?
Dude, yes.
We both got two different cars now.
It matters. It definitely matters. Cause it happened.
Yeah, well, I got these and we both got a car, right? So it don't matter.
It do.
That piece of smell amazing.
It is. Oh, it is.
I got the LeBron 17, man, in the arenas. I bought these to hoop in. I haven't played in them yet. I know Cody played them, but I haven't played them yet.
Yep.
But it's just a normal LeBron colorway GR. I just bought to hoop in.
That shoe got some story in it, too.
What? Oh, yeah. Cody hooped in these. He was finna fight at a church.
You call him the lockdown, what number are those?
17.
The lockdown 17. Because that nigga didn't score a bucket. Oh, not one.
So you clapped him that bad?
That bad, bro.
Kyrie 3 Dukes. I got these on sneakers. I think this was like, no, this was second Duke. The Lucky Charm Kyrie 4s. Mm-hmm. And I made these the 7s to look like these. But this shoe. I literally hate this shoe now, bro.
That hurts you. It's when you hurt yourself.
Yeah, this is a shoe I injured myself in, bro. Like, the bottom, like, bro, like, the 4s and the 7s got the worst bottom. Like, your foot slide in them, bro. My foot literally slid in it, and it made my knee buckle. So that's why my knee is literally out of condition.
Those are clean.
Yeah, these are... Like, I remember I thought these was like fake. I didn't even think these was actually coming out, but like this, like a what the, like it got the confettis, the tacos, SpongeBob, the lobsters,
and they got that LGBTQ.
Yeah, they got the Be True, they got the pineapples, they got the Paranormans, they just got everything on here. So when this shoe came out, I made sure I got it. But I would never hoop in the Kyrie 4 or 7 or since they got the bottom of the 4s, the Hybrids. Them the only two Kyries I ever injured myself in, the 4s and the 7s. Mm. And these right here, this is like one of the most beautiful shoes I ever laid my eyes on. Mm-hmm. Like the gold is like...
reflective, bro.
Yeah, that's just like a beautiful gold. I remember like LeBron wore them. I remember they had them on 2K and everything.
That 11, those are just clean. Like those red ones, bro. Those red ones are disgusting. Red one,
oh my God. Yeah. Bro. Yeah, this colorway right here is just... it means a lot to me because I had the fake version and it was like pretty bad.
Yeah, they were.
Like this, the King's Pride, those was the fucking... dude, them shouldn't even be called Pride, period. Yeah, these the King's Pride. I love this shoe. I need to cop another pair because this one's starting to like peel some places. Like, yeah, so I need another pair. These, I made these on Nike ID because of the pink. Yeah, like I said, I like loud colors and they gave us an option. But the first time in a long time with like pink and just loud colors like that. With the LeBron 8 Tune Squads. I like this colorway a lot. Literally got LeBron right there, Bugs right there.
That's clean.
And they got like stuff.
That little stuff in there. Clean. Like,
stuff from the Serververse type stuff. Yeah, this Nike been on it, bro. I ain't gonna lie. The KD6 Bamboos. I remember my friend Brandon, he had these. I think that's probably the only reason I got them, because like the memories of them. And then the green is like crazy. Light shine off of them. It's just a beautiful shoe, bro. These, I remember the alternate grapes. I remember I won a raffle for them. Oh, my friend, well, my cousin Devin, he liked to see people drove. So I was talking about this shoe a lot. And then when I figured out I won the raffle for him, I kept sending, like I was spamming him with a picture of these.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, dude, if you don't get those, I'm gonna be dying. Then on the day when they actually came out, I didn't tell him I won a raffle, nigga. The day they actually came out, he thought I didn't get them. So he sent like a million laughing emojis, bro. But I sent him a picture like I was asleep with the shoe on my head or something like that.
He was dumb, bro.
Yeah. I did something cringy, bro. The Fire Red 4s, I hit on sneakers for these, size 10 and a half. Why did I just say the size, bro? Probably because I wear 11 and they attend that. But yeah, Fire Red 4s.
Yeah, I think I'm 11 too, bro. I be wearing 10 and a half. I think I'm 11, man.
This is, this. MJ did it with this one, bro. Fire Red.
MJ didn't do nothing.
Ooh. Warm.
Yeah.
But yeah, these are what the Kyrie 6s tried to make them look like the what the Kobe 8s.
I like the back.
Yeah, back. I put the, you can see the, I don't know what it's called, iridescent, something like that.
Iridescence.
Yeah. It's one of my favorite shoes. And Nike don't give us the option to make these no more. I was going to make with the Kyrie every year, but we can't do it. The Aqua Kyrie 3s. It's just the Tiffany blue. It's like, bro, you don't see that every day, man.
Blue?
Tiffany Tuesday.
And I got these Curry 8s.
I should wear those more.
I'm probably going to hoop in the next time I hoop. I said that about the other shoe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to hoop in these. They comfortable, bro. Like, they
look comfortable.
Like, look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, I hooped in them once, but I was going through a phase where like, I feel like if I'm playing bad, I should just put on the KD14s and everything will change. But that's not the case no more. But yeah, just like the International Women's Day, Curry 8s. Curry 9s look amazing, by the way. Oregon 5s.
I wish they just kept the O at the back, though.
Yeah, some people cut this little thing off and put the O on there they sell.
That's clean.
Yeah, but this colorway ain't clean, bro. Like, I like how they doing the college colorways, bro. Like the UNC Force. Mm-hmm. North Carolina blue just always been kind to like different. Vision Racer, Jaden Smith. Do you see it, Chip?
No.
Like, I'm a big Jaden Smith fan. Like, I've been a Jaden Smith fan since, like, 2013. Is that around the time?
Yeah.
Like, 2013, so been following him for years, and now he do the Vision Racer thing. Yeah, pink, bro. Like, you gotta be loud. Like, these right here, this probably... I'm in the process of selling these right now. I don't want to, but you gotta do what you gotta do. George 6 electric greens. I'm barely going on, bro. Raging Bull 5s. Like, these kinda like my beaters, bro. Like, every time I just put on the random shoes, it always be these, bro.
Interesting.
But I like how this, like the bull type thing. You
see the shark that? Teeth.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, and it's like the bull horns. Yeah.
It's dumb. Everybody need a pair of these. Like,
no.
Everybody.
I think Bubba got out there. Can I see everything else? I just remember I used to watch videos about the 2-3, because that was one of the biggest flaws on the other ones. It's 2-3.
I remember I kept begging my brother, Bubba, to let me get his pair, but he wasn't going, so I bought my own pair. What's the Jordan 5s? Oh, this one right here.
Look at the silver, bro.
Yeah.
Look at the silver on the shark teeth, too.
Yeah, these it, bro. Mm-hmm. They got the Bel Air inside.
Mm. Bel Air.
It's yellow. I like the yellow one too. I like the yellow color in the Bel Air.
Bel Air blue too.
I got these KD 5s. This was like after KD signed to Brooklyn. And it's the black and white. So I saw these. It was cheap, so I just got to hoop in. Best Christmas colorway to ever release.
Facts.
LeBron 11s.
Dude, LeBron 11s have clean colorways.
Yeah, that's when Nike was on them, man. I mean, they still doing their thing now, but back then they was on it. It's a beautiful, beautiful shoe.
They starting Moses Brown.
Yeah, I made these because my son, his first team ever that he ever played for, they was called the Rockies. But you can only put 6 letters on the thing. So I just put Rocky, made it translucent. I was like, the dirt you see is from the baseball field.
Makes sense.
Yeah. And it was purple and orange, so yeah, I had to get them. And then on the back, say CJ, I don't know if you can see it.
Yeah, you can see it.
It say CJ, so this is special. I get it, this is like a bondage type of shoe for me and him. Reached out to this guy named Showtime. I think Showtime 0012. I do customs. This one, he actually reached out back. He gave me the LeBron 15 South Beaches. They was never gonna release them, so I got them customized. And I definitely do not regret it. And this shoe right here is, I made these on Nike ID. It was the KD13 music. It was like music option or something like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this shoe, oh my goodness, dude. Dude, look at this shoe.
Looks pretty
good. You don't see these colors on the shoe a lot. I know I'm probably gonna wear these tomorrow.
100%.
Not 100, but I might, if I wear some Brooklyn, I'm gonna wear these. But like, you just, this like, this not even a normal, but it's like a lavender purple and then pink.
Mm-hmm.
It just sits the shoe.
Wait, is that design inside the Nike, huh?
Yeah, it's like...
Let me see.
That's the music option that it was.
Oh, I see it now.
I could have put it down there, but I thought the purple made it look better. Mm-hmm. That's all. Well, not really. I got these, what, the LeBron 17s on.
Ooh.
Yeah, then my tattoo. Like, I got the KD logo, Kyrie, the Nike sign. I wanted the Nike sign bigger. But that's another story. I got the LeBron logo, Kobe. Yeah, all Nike. Because I'm a Nike brand athlete.
Nike brand athlete?
Yeah.
No, you're not.
No, I'm not. But, like, Nike, Foot Locker, Champs, anybody. If y'all want to co-sign your boy, send me some free shoes or something, get at me.
Get at you.
But yeah, that was the video. Like, comment, subscribe. Tell me which shoe is your favorite. And yeah, I'm trying to build this channel up. I don't really use this channel. I'll be on my other channel with my friends. Mm-hmm. Called The Losers Club, where we do reactions, skits, gaming, everything else. So I'm going to try to keep my shoe stuff on this channel.
Maybe they want to buy something too, maybe.
Yeah, if you, I'm in a selling mood, so if you want to buy something from me, hit me up. And I'm not gonna say I'll do this channel by myself. My friend Devin, my cousin Devin, he's supposed to be with me, but he be slacking. Like, I want to do like basketball stuff, like performance videos, just shoe videos, like on feet, mm-hmm. and stuff like that on this channel. So like, comment, subscribe. Let's try to get this channel up.
How many subscribers you got right now?
Like 60-something. Yeah.
First goal is 1,000, bro.
Yeah. Thanks for watching. I'm out.